And now we will learn more about paying business expenses from personal funds. In this case, we will learn how to track costs by job. What if you track expenses by jobs or by class? In that case, you can't do the method or the procedure that we learned in the previous video when the owner takes money from their personal funds and spends it for business. In a case like this, where you track expenses by jobs or by class, you have to do something called a QuickBooks workaround. Workaround means that we have to use QuickBooks slightly differently than from how it was designed. In this case, we have to make a capital investment account for the owner as a bank type of account. This is because only a bank type of account appears in the write checks window. Everybody knows capital investment is equity. We are simply adjusting how we use the software so that it will work for us in our situation. Let me show you what I mean. Here's the file from the previous video. Here's the chart of accounts that we're using for both the previous video and this video. Now, in the previous video, I told you, double-click on the owner's capital account in the chart of accounts, and you get the register. And you can record any event where the owner took money from his or her personal funds and spent it for business. And in the previous example, we had Holden spending his personal funds, whether it's credit card, bank account, or cash. He's spending his personal funds for the company's delivery expense. You cannot use this method if you track costs by job or by class. And it's very obvious the reason why. There is no field, there is no column in the equity register to put in for class or for job. So you have to do the workaround and add the additional investment account. So now, let's go ahead and add an account to the chart of accounts to be able to record all of the transactions when Holden pays from his personal cash, his personal bank account, or personal credit card account. We click Add New. We choose Bank Type of Account because, again, we're working around the way the software behaves. We click Continue and type in Holden paid from personal. And after we save and close, we now have an account to record all of the events when Holden pays from his personal funds for business reasons. And now let's do an example. Let's imagine on April 17th, Holden paid $300 from his personal funds for a company delivery. This delivery was for the specific customer, Dana Carvey, and we use the write a checks window and select the Holden capital account that we just created as the pay from account at the top of the window. So, let's go ahead and do that. Before we do that, we'll take a look at the trial balance. You can see delivery expense is only $500. After we pay this delivery expense for that specific customer, even though it came from Holden's personal funds, delivery expense will increase by what he pays because it's delivery for this business. And delivery expense will increase to $800, and the new account, Holden paid from personal, is going to show up here for the first time as $300. From the main menu, we click Banking, write a check. Now, we choose, instead of choosing cash and bank, the pay from account is Holden's paid from personal. Just click OK when you get this message. We put in $300. Normally, there would be a payee like UPS or FedEx. And if we go to the bottom left, we can see that we can choose delivery expense. Remember, the service that the business received when Holden paid from personal was delivery expense. But this window gives us the ability to choose the specific customer or the specific job that this payment was for. Now when we click Save and Close, you can see Holden's paid from personal shows up for the first time as a $300 credit balance because it's appropriate to credit an equity account when an owner invests from their personal funds. And of course, delivery expense increased to the amount that we said it would, $800. The most important point is this report here, Profit and Loss by Job. You can see the Dana Carvey job was assigned $300 for delivery expense. And that's the way to assign a personal payment for business to a particular company job. Now, to all you naysayers out there, let's discuss the consequences of this particular method. One consequence is that the new equity account will show up in the assets section of your balance sheet. Well, for people who only need the trial balance and nothing else, and they can look at these numbers and understand what's going on, it doesn't really matter that the 300 is listed towards the top rather than the bottom. But if you really need your balance sheet perfect, what you can do is you can customize the reports or export to Excel. You only report a balance sheet once every period, whether it be month, quarter, or year. So on a day-to-day basis, it's better to do this method and simply take a couple of extra steps at the end of the year to adjust the way your balance sheet looks. What about the only other consequence? Well, we already have a capital account for the owner's investment, and it's an equity type of account. So what do? You can just make a journal entry at the end of the period from Holden's paid from personal, transfer it over to Holden's capital in his equity account. You don't have to do that if you like to keep separate the pay from personal from other types of investment, like when he simply took money and put it in the company bank account. But let's take a look at what the journal entry would look like, and let's do it at the end of April. When we take a look at the trial balance, what we want to do is move this 300 paid from personal to Holden's capital equity. We're imagining it's the end of the quarter or the end of the fiscal period or the end of the year, and we want to take all the money that accumulated in this new account, which is telling us how much money he spent for business from his personal, and put it where the accountants say it belongs, which is Holden's capital equity. Well, to make a credit balance zero, we would make a debit to that account to make it zero, and then credit Holden's capital equity, and that will go up to $30,800. From the main menu, I'm going to click Company, Make Journal Entry. And again, we're imagining it's the end of the fiscal period, whether it's month, quarter, or year. And the account that we debit is Holden's paid from personal. We wipe out the $300 credit balance by debiting it. And the balancing credit goes to the account that it belongs in, Holden's capital equity. So we can simply make this adjustment at the end of each fiscal period in order to be sure that the balance sheet looks exactly the way we need. When we click Save and Close, you can see Holden's paid from personal went down to zero because we transferred that $300 into this one, Holden's capital equity, and it became $30,800.